Hey guys, what's up? It's Apollo here, and welcome back to the Adventures of Longus Dongus. Now, today is going to be the final episode of the series, and I know some of you guys are going to be really saddened by that, but don't worry, there's going to be more series in the future, different storylines, different characters, different mods. It's going to be awesome. This is only the start of our Bannerlord adventure. Now, please don't skip ahead. I have a very important message for you guys. If this series meant a lot to you, I think you want to listen in to why this series means a lot to me. So please try not to skip ahead. I have a very important message too. It won't take too long, so just sit back and hear this story. So this series will probably go down as my favorite series playthrough ever, past and future. And I know that for sure because, well, I was going through a little bit of a slump. And I was kind of losing passion for YouTube and, Total War. I was getting kind of a little tired of Total War, and I needed to do something different. I was afraid of doing anything different because I thought, you know, if I work really hard on something new and nobody likes it, then, you know, I feel like, you know, it's just, I was scared, right? And I wanted to kind of break that shell of Total War battles and do new and different things. Well, one day, a subscriber reached out to me. His name is Edwin Von Klackeruth. I don't know if that's his real name. But Edwin here messaged me and opened up about a struggle he was having in his life. And he said, "Apollo, you don't know me, but I've been fighting cancer for over a year, and I'm going into surgery tomorrow." He said, "I'm not sure if I'll wake up, but I just need some encouragement from my favorite YouTuber. Something that I can think of before I'm put out, and hopefully something I can think of when I wake up. Just please, for the love of God, give me something. So I can at least die with the knowledge that a YouTuber I've watched for years acknowledged me before I died." Now, I didn't really know what to say to that because it's not every day you get a message like that. And I just told him, you know, I'm just praying for him and to please message me, when you wake up from surgery and you know, keep me up to date and thank you for watching my stuff. And I'm glad, you know, that I'm your favorite YouTuber, and I'm glad I can bring some comfort to you in a challenging time. So he had the surgery on July 5th, and on July 6th, I got a message, and it said, he just said, "Awaiting results." And I was like, "Oh, you know, did you have the surgery?" And he said, "They're about to do some scans to see if they did it correctly, and they got what they needed to get out, which is, the cancer." And then, I told him that, I'm here for you, man. And just, you know, keep me up to date. And he said, you know, "Thank you for the support. It means a lot." And I told him, "No night left behind." I just want him to know that, like, hey, like, you know, I'm thinking about you, and I'm not going to just read this message and carry on with my day. I'm thinking about you. Well, unfortunately, on July 8th, he messaged me. He says, "Well, goodbye, Apollo. They found a tumor they can't remove in my brain, and it doesn't look too good." And, you know, we just talked about, like, potential treatments they could do, like chemo. He said they could do a process called debulking or something like that, where they remove as much of the tumor as they can as soon as I am able. They're going to do an intense chemo and radiation sessions. But he also told me, "I know this may seem like an odd request, but could you revisit Bannerlord? I'm going to need something to cheer me up and cheer me up next week, but I understand if it's a no." I mean, it's really the least I could do. Like, I was just like, "Yeah, what do you want? You want to see a campaign? Do you want to see online battles? What's your favorite?" And he just told me he wanted to see a campaign. So I started a live stream campaign. If you guys remember, Longus Dongus was actually a live stream before I decided to make videos out of it. And he saw the live streams and he said, "Thanks for the streams, man. I hope Longus Dongus doesn't become un-Alongus." And I was like, "Hey, no problem, man." But after doing those streams, I felt like doing a campaign would be a little bit more interesting. I could do some editing. I can put in some jokes. And, you know, in the back of my mind, I was like, "Hey, let's just make this really good. You know, let's just Hey, make Edwin's day a little bit better. Hopefully, you know, this helps him get through his battle, you know. Just something to make his day a little bit better. And I was a little nervous too because I was doing something completely different. I mean, I've done Bannerlord campaigns, but nothing like this, like highly edited with like different kinds of jokes and stuff. So I was a little nervous about it, just how it would perform. But in the back of my mind, I thought, hey, it's making someone's day better. So that's all that matters. And I start this series and it's a huge success, guys. I mean, like, I'm blown away by the support. I made a couple videos mentioning how appreciative I am about the support and how awesome the series has been for my channel and just my YouTube career. Like, there was a time where I applied for a job because I thought I couldn't keep up with, you know, all my payments and I needed something a bit more stable. And this series just changed everything. It changed everything and it drastically I'm not dreading making videos anymore. I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited. Not only the recording process, but the editing process. Thanks to you guys and the support that you've shown throughout this series. And that's something I'm grateful about. But it's not really too much about me because on September 20th, Edwin's friend logged into Edwin's account and this is what he told me. He said, this is Edwin's friend here. Edwin gave me his login info so he could thank you as he wasn't in any condition to do so himself. Edwin has been hospitalized due to an undetected tumor that caused him to have a major stroke, which is unlikely he will recover from. He just wanted to thank you for making these videos as he is and has been enjoying them very much. I personally do not think he will last long enough to thank you, but he has been deteriorating over the past few days. He's also glad after watching today's episode that his idea has grown your channel by a lot and he is glad he is able to help change your life for the better. If he recovers, he can tell you himself. Otherwise, thank you for making my friend happy in his final weeks. The fact that he reached out to me, called me his favorite YouTuber, and that one of the few things he wanted to just help him get through this struggle is some videos from me. And that really meant a lot to me. That really meant a lot to me. So later, he told me that he was being transferred into a better hospital and that he unfortunately fell into a coma early in the morning of September 23rd, which was the damage caused by the stroke. And he's at a better hospital, so hopefully they will be able to treat him better. So I was, of course, just, you know, praying for him and hoping that I'd get a message one day and it would be Edwin saying, hey, man, like, I'm doing better. But tragically, today, September 29th, the morning of September 29th, Edwin's friend gave me the news that Edwin passed away this morning. I wanted to tell you this story because this whole series basically exists because of Edwin. So I just wanted to dedicate. I know this is silly. It's a silly little YouTube series, but it's all I can really do, I guess. But I just wanted to dedicate this entire series to Edwin. This episode, this entire series, and that's why this series will always be special to me because, it's not, you know, and I don't want to make this about me because this is Edwin's story, but the fact that he, in the last few weeks of his life, one of the things he thought about was, you know, kept messaging me. You know, call me his favorite YouTuber and, you know, wanting me to do a series for him. And I just hope the videos brought some joy. I am a little disappointed he couldn't see the end of the series, you know. I was kind of hoping he'd wake up and he would see the finale. And I just want to say my heart reaches out to anyone out there who's struggling through this. Something like Edwin, you know, cancer or a family member, my heart goes out to you. I know it's not fair. It's really not fair. But Edwin here, man, I mean, talk about absolute, you know, warrior battling through this for a year. I guess it goes back to that saying, no night left behind. I know that might be kind of cringe or cliche or I don't know. I guess I just wanted to share that Edwin had a huge impact on my life, even though I barely knew him, and he messaged me a few messages, and I didn't really get to know him closely. He inspired me, and by you enjoying this series, you were inspired by him as well. So my condolences to Edwin's family, and I don't know if they'll ever see this, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry that this happened, and I do want to do something in honor of Edwin here. So what I'm going to be doing is all of the money I make from today's episode, I'm going to donate that to a charity. So the charity is going to be, it's called Gamers Outreach. Basically, it helps kids who are going through a sickness, whether it be cancer or whatever. They hook them up with some awesome gaming consoles in their hospital room. It just makes, you know, makes a hospital stay a little bit easier. Yeah, I've had my fair share of hospital stays, whether it was me or someone in my family, and it sucks, you know. And so I know, you know, when you're in there for weeks or even months at a time, it's really tough. Now, the Gamers Outreach on Charity Navigation is where they rate charities. It's rated 100. This is a really good charity. They give 80% of their total profits towards actual, like, you know, helping people, where most charities only do like 50% or even less, like 30%. It's really sad. But I know times are tough today financially and really in every way, but if you have a dollar or two, I have a link. I started a campaign in honor of Edwin. It's called Leave No Night Behind. I know it's cheesy, but if you want to support the charity, you can. It's you can make it in honor of Edwin, you know, in memory of Edwin, just to help other. I don't know how old Edwin was. I assume he was pretty young, but this will definitely help young kids out there who are going through a tough battle have some sort of comfort in their struggle. So anyways, guys, thank you so much for listening to the story, and thank you for donating. If you can't donate because money's tight or whatever, I completely understand. Don't forget that all money made from this episode, I will be donating towards the charity, towards the fundraiser. So, you know, maybe click on some ads, you know, do something to get the money going. Of course, like the video, share the video. Yeah, enjoy today's episode, and then this one's for Edwin. Maybe, you know, I didn't get to meet you in this life, but maybe in another. So thank you, guys. Enjoy. The Adventures of Alongus Dongus continues. And can we just take a moment and appreciate all the land we have here? All the epic battles, sieges, diplomacy, the fights, the struggle. Oh, it's been a lot of fun. Well, in the first time in forever, we have peace. All right, first time in forever, we have peace, guys, and it's nice. So during this peace time, I'm going to let my vassals, first off, get out of my army. Just disband. Yes, everybody go. Second off, we've got a bunch of loot we need to sell. Okay, 42,000 gold, not bad. So since we finally have peace, now is the time that we need to go and recruit some more lords. That's one of the major things that my faction really needs right now. I have so much space, but not enough lords. Also, having peace is gonna give my faction time to heal up, recruit a ton of troops, and let those troops rank up in experience. I think that's one of the... Oh, wow. The Sturgeons are sieging us? Are you serious? Look at this. I thought this was like the Western Empire, but yeah, no. Let's just go in here and just send in the troops. Help them out. Holy crap, we gained 53 troops from that battle? Okay, that maxes out our army. That's pretty sweet. And we got some more loot from it? Okay. So yeah, as I was saying before we were rudely interrupted by the Sturgeons, we need to let our vassals heal up. Not just like physically, but spiritually, all right? We have been at war for so long, it's ridiculous. Every time that I think we're gonna end a war, just someone else declares war on us. It's just a never ending. It's just never ending. Yeah. And that's the major advantage of the other factions, is that they weren't always in war, so they were able to train up their troops and have these massive, powerful elite armies. Sure, we have the manpower, but we need more training for the lads, because too many troops are dying and not getting full training. And I think if we could just have a couple months, all right, just a couple months of peace, then we can, you know, we can field some of the most professional and largest armies the world has ever seen. So we're gonna head back to where the Northern Empire has one little castle and all the vassals like chilling here. We're going to try to convince some of the Northern Empire vassals to join us, because I think they're going to be the most desperate to want to join my faction. All right, so we found this guy. He looks like, you know, he looks, I don't know, maybe he wants to join us. Okay, yeah, so here we go. This is our first chance, and so far, not so good. Okay, there we go. Success. Come on. You know you want to join me. What? All right, this is going to be it. Critical. Yes. Oh, yes. Man, we desperately needed that. That was our last chance, and we did it. All right, so he's going to need some money. Unfortunately, he's demanding a lot of money. Usually what that means is that he's pretty powerful. And there we go. We added another vassal to the empire. The only thing, though, is I don't know if we can do that again. We only have 143K. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is actually head south and manage some of my territories. Because we need to lessen the garrison strength, because I just can't afford it. It's just, I think they just are, I'm giving them too much money to muster a huge garrison militia force, and it's causing me to go negative. So we need to go over there and fix that. Man, I really cannot stress this enough, how awesome it's been to just not be at war. Like, I remember in the early days of this campaign, I would beg for war. You know, I would just like, oh, come on, it's been like 20 minutes without a war. Now it's like, finally, some peace and quiet in this damn place. Oh, and it looks like we found some other vassals that we were separated from. We could go ahead and go to the tavern and get him to join us, and then turn him. I think he was a merchant, so we'll go ahead and make him a merchant again. Yep, I would like to make a caravan in this town. I accept the cost, and here you go. So we got another caravan going. That's going to help our finances there a little bit. Now, our food here is not looking too good. It's currently negative. So I'm actually going to go ahead and improve the orchard here. That's going to cause our loyalty to go down, but it should complete before it gets too low. And we'll also increase the money here a little bit just to make sure they finish it on time. Yeah, I mean, look at this garrison, guys. There's 611 troops in here. Oh my gosh. So in terms of modifying the garrisons of these two cities that are under my control are on the front line of a potential enemy, the Azurai. Now, this city here is pretty safe in my territory. It's kind of near a border of an enemy, but if the enemy attacks, they'll probably go for this castle first. I'm not really worried about the Kuzates, and honestly, I'm not too worried about the Azurai either. So I'm just going to lower the garrison budget by quite a lot. So this is pretty new to me, so it actually took me a little while to figure out how to do it. So if you go to clan and then go to parties, and then this shows your garrisons. And right here, they're on unlimited wage. I'm going to turn that off. And wow, right now their current wage is 3,000. I'm going to cut that in half and make it about 1,500. And I'm going to do the same for the other faction or other cities as well. Just like that. So hopefully that helps our budget here. I don't know if it's updated yet. It might take a couple days. Hopefully that helps our budget, but for now, I need to get my caravans going again. Like, I have all these companions, but some of them need to be told. Like, I need to reform caravans. For example, the spice vendor here. Where is she? Oh, she's all the way over here. I think they chill inside your territory. So yeah, let's just go over there and reestablish another caravan. We gotta get our economy going. All right, so we made it to this town. We're gonna go ahead and go to the tavern, get our spice vendor back into the party, then go directly to, it doesn't, we'll just go to this carpenter guy and we will set up another caravan. Okay, there we go. Caravan number two, reestablished. Well, guys, it was fun while it lasted. The Volandians, man, they just can't leave me the fuck alone. So here I was on my way to go find another companion that needed to be in another caravan to really improve our economy. Our economy is now positive. We've been making 1,000 per day now thanks to the recent changes, some civil management. But I wanted to get a couple more caravans set up, and then I was going, if in case you didn't know, I don't have any of my my party armies. For example, you can create new parties, or I don't have any of them set up because it costs too much, and that would greatly improve the strength of our faction. So I'm gonna go set up another caravan and reestablish some party armies. You know, like companion armies that cost zero influence to call into my own army. Hopefully we have enough money for that, so we'll see. And look at the, man, it sucks, dude. I was having such a good time. It was so peaceful. I could do some management, civil management. Could I, like, honestly, I don't even care. If could I negotiate, oh, they want 11,000 gold per day. No one's gonna do that. No one's gonna do that. All right, so we're at Xenica. And this is where I have the leopard guy, leopardess. I don't know. Oh, it's a girl, my bad. And we're gonna go ahead and make a caravan for her as well. All right, there we go. Another caravan established. Now that we have a caravan established, it's time. Hopefully we have enough money, right? I think we can establish more caravans, but I'm just gonna save the rest of my money and focus on the war at hand. So we're gonna go to our parties and we are going to reestablish some armies here. So we're gonna start with Ira. You know what? For now, I'm just gonna do Ira. That's it. And I'll give her 1,000 gold budget. I know that's not great, but it's all I can afford. So hopefully she can build a strong army that we can summon to our ranks. So we're gonna head to the front line of the war. We do have two armies currently on the march right now, an army of 600 and an army of 1,100. They are sieging our furthest most city. They most likely will take it, but we're gonna very gladly take it back. And then once we take this back, I'm taking this city right here. I mean, they're literally right next to each other. It'd be stupid not to. And we have a lot of lords that have not been summoned yet. I mean, this is the beauty of having so many lords in your kingdom. Cool, so I just summoned a bunch of lords that are no more than 4 days away, and I'm gonna start to head to the front line of the war, because the Volandians are asking for more. I hate the Volandians. But hey, I mean, you know, having a couple days of peace, literally only a couple days, it brought our total strength up to 21,000 strength. I mean, that's pretty good. I believe, after looking at all the different factions, we are the strongest faction. Yeah, like the closest one is the Volandians at 13,000. So pretty sweet. Amazingly enough, they have not taken the city yet and we're almost in range. We might be able to get there in time to help it. Again, even if we can't, it's not a big deal. We're gonna just take it back. Oh, bingo. Cha-ching, 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 cha-ching-cha-ching. Look who it is, it's the fat cat himself. The king of the Volandians. King of Dunos. I'm coming right for you. Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, we don't always get this opportunity, so let's go capture their king. All right, guys, here we are. This is a pretty cool little village here. We really don't get enough village battles. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not really a fan of village battles because they're just big clusters. And yeah, looking at the army, I'm not too worried about this. He has a lot of cav, but that's about it. And honestly, melee cav, it's not that difficult to deal with. His infantry is moving forward as we speak. There goes his cav. So I'm gonna back up here. I've got my army to pretty much same formation. I mean, look at that. They're just all clumped up, ready to go. So once they get close, I'm probably just gonna charge the infantry and then charge the cav. And oh, I'm stuck. I'm literally, okay, hold on guys, hold on. Commander's stuck. Okay, here we go. Yeah, fire into him. Fire into him. I'll move up the infantry a little bit closer. And let's go ahead and charge in the cav. There we go. Let's get in there and give it to him. Excellent. Have fun, guys. Remember, this is the King's Army. Get it, boys. Get it. Oh, look at that. I don't even think we've lost anyone yet. Holy moly. Holy moly. Oh, there we go. We finally lost someone. There we go. All right. But still, this is what I'm talking about. Little bit of peace time. Little bit of peace time, and my army's already that much better in quality. Nobody likes you, Volandians. Nobody. So, hate to say it. Hate to say it, dude. But, Dearthhurt, your wife was, she snuck into my DMs when she was asking for my cock. Okay, that's not a true story, but, and I simply blocked her because I'm a happily married man. I would never even pretend to imagine to cheat on my wife, Ira. Ira, she's beautiful, you know? Ira, you're beautiful and I love you, baby. But seriously, Dearthhurt is a cuck. No, Dearthhurt, I won't sleep with your wife. Come on. All right, I'm just going to tell everyone to charge. It's a pretty straightforward battle, like literally straightforward. They just charged us and we crushed them. We crushed them, fam. We got a couple stragglers making a run for it. They do have a decent amount of these sharpshooters, which are actually pretty deadly, so it's good that we caught them early and we're wrapping them up. We're wrangling them up like a cowboy. One less archer we have to worry about. Also, I noticed, like, another thing about the Volandians at this point of their empire, they're losing a bunch of territory, mostly the Britannian territory. So their army are now more true to the Volandians, mostly just Volandian troops. No more Britannian armies. The Britannians have joined me now. Okay, there we go. So we lost 15 men. Not bad at all. All right, King Dearthhurt, you're my prisoner now. How does that make you feel? Probably makes you feel like crap. Oh, and we unlocked 75 troops. So that was a much appreciated victory. I wasn't going to say it's a much needed victory, because we didn't necessarily need to win that. It was just good to get the king so early. And wow, that's an army of 400. Oh, no. They have a lot more. Okay. So how many do we got here? Oh, and then we're coming. Oh, dude, you guys took too long. Oh, you made a big mistake, didn't you? Didn't you, governor? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, easy peasy right here. All right, let's have ourselves. You know what? Hold on, I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna wait until daytime, actually. I know that's kind of petty of me. I just don't like fighting at night. All right, let's go back in there and help out. Oh, well, now it's very once. We'll just send in the troops. Sorry, guys. I mean, it was kind of close at the beginning, but yeah, you're my prisoner now. Okay, so we got a bunch of loot and everything, so we're gonna go to the city and support the city. And what I mean by support the city, I mean sell our junk. Look at all these stupid saddles because of the stupid Volandians. Sweet, 63K right there, easy peasy. So I'm just gonna sell 21 prisoners because we were 21 over the max that we can carry, just to make a little bit of cheddar. I like keeping the prisoners because it adds, like, if I need more troops, I can quickly just let the prisoners join my army. But for now, we're still waiting for our vassals to join us. So I could try to get this guy. I'm curious, would any of them be interested in joining? Probably not yet. Anyways, we're just gonna chill here and wait for more of my vassals to join me. And then we're gonna start sieging some territory. I absolutely love the fact that I almost have three armies here worth of, well, I'll have 1,000, but eventually these armies will all have 1,000 troops, and then we're gonna go and just push and take so much territory. It's gonna be beautiful. It's gonna make me cry. All right, so I've got about 700 ready to go, so I'm just gonna go ahead and begin the siege. Ah, interesting. There's about 600 defenders in here. Well, that shouldn't be too much of a problem. Also, three more vassals still need to join us, which will really help get our numbers up. You know, as much as I love peacetime, I do also love war, and I love the fact that the Volandians, you know, I was a bit surprised that they declared war against us, because we're so much stronger than them now. It's kind of sad. I'm feeling kind of sad for them. All right, cool. So now we've got the entire army complete with 1,100 troops. Our other armies are hopefully moving around. Honestly, I might tell them to just be aggressive. So if we go to diplomacy, because we really brought the fight to them, you know? So I'm going to tell them to be offensive. So maybe they'll go and take out a bunch of cities. I don't really know, but I hope they do something. Yeah, it looks like this army's moving over to take a castle. That's pretty cool. Whoa, look who showed up with an army of 800. That's so cute. I remember when I could muster armies of 800. I remember my first army of 800. That's so cute. All right, let's go ahead and lead the assault. I can feel the winds of change, guys. The winds of change. I'm telling you, that peacetime made the world of difference. It made a big difference. It gave my vassals just a little bit of time to rest. I mean, literally, the last, like, I don't know, 100 wars we've been in, it's been non-stop. Very few moments of peace. And it wasn't even a true peace, guys. I mean, we were still technically at war with the Sturgeons, but, you know, the Sturgeons are a bit of a joke now, so I don't really count it. But yeah, I mean, it's been good. Peacetime is very helpful in these situations because it lets you level up your troops and build strong, full armies. That's just what we needed. That's why we were struggling so much against, say, like the Western Empire, because they were perfectly healthy and we are just war-torn and tired. But it really does feel different, guys. It really does. My vassals are mobilizing. We're being hyper-aggressive. We're attacking. We're destroying armies. The Valandians look weak. I mean, they were only able to muster an army of 800. I mean, that's real weak. Especially when we have three armies of almost 1,000. There goes the tower. They've moved up infantry to support against the tower. So I've got a good angle on the infantry. I'm just going to go for headshots here. Whoa, hey. I am littered with arrows right now. If we check my third person view, I've lost more than half my health, but that's okay. I'm just going to chill back here. I'm in no rush. I'm just going to support where I can, kill some of these guys from the flank, and eventually I think I'm going to move up once my infantry engages. All right, time to join the fun. I am very low on health, so I got to be careful here. But yeah, let's go in and kick their ass. Woo, look at this. Look at this mosh pit. I'm just going to try to slide over to the flank. This is my go-to tactic here. Try to get to the flank of the formation and then get behind the enemy. Like so. Oh, look at these guys. Oh, I feel bad killing them. Just surrender, man. You don't have to fight for the Valandians. You're proud Batanians. I will let you govern yourselves. Just, you serve me now. All right? If you just surrender right now. 3, 2. Well, okay, you're not surrendering. You're mine now. Yeah, we're just going ham. They don't even know I'm back here. They can't hold on for much longer. Where are you guys running to? Where are you running to? There's no running in baseball. Oh, wait, no, there is. All right, you got to be careful with those jumps. Too low. Oh, my gosh. All right, some reinforcements are up here. Yeah, push them back. There we go. Yeah, good job, team. All right, the good guys are winning. Guys, isn't it strange that in every war ever, the good guys always win? I mean, it's not like the victor always writes the story. Am I right, guys? I mean, the good guys just always win. Well, the Valandians are on the run, and we're just going to chop them down. It's a cool settlement here. I like it. It's going to make a nice vacation home during the hot summers. We can travel up here and spend a little bit cooler summer. You know, during winter, it's, you know, I ain't chill. During winter, nah. It's a frozen hellscape up here, but summer? Yeah, I could see myself here at summer. Yep, this is where I'm going to put my new mansion, right here. Right here, guys. You like this spot? Maybe further back. It's too close to the walls. I don't want any peasants around me, you know? It just makes me sad seeing poor people. I'm telling you, I'm like the Jeff Bezos of Calradia. Ew, gross, poor people. All right, cool. So we won the day. 71 lost their lives in taking the settlement, but they shall be forgotten. I mean, let's be real here. I'm not going to remember them, are you? I mean, after all the battles we had, do you remember anyone who dies in this game? No. So we're going to send in the troops. I'm too injured. Can't go in. There we go. And hey, we unlocked 4 troops, so that's nice. I'm actually going to go ahead and unlock all these prisoners. I know it's going to be more than we can hold, but what we're going to do is just put the extras into the garrison. Okay, awesome. So we took another city. My vassals are currently sieging this city with 700 troops. It looks like they've begun the siege because they're taking casualties. We've got another army over here that's gathering up some forces, and I believe that's all of our armies. So it's going to be up to us to basically... I'm just going to go for the major cities. I'll let my vassals go for the castles. So I think I'm going to go to Pen Canach. Or I could go... Yeah, Pen Canach. I think that's the last Batanian city. All that's going to be left are the true Valandian cities. So that's going to be fun. But it's probably important that we take on this army here. So they don't mass up and try to take some of the cities that we've been taking. We can now trade away this city, which I'm going to give it, of course, to the new guy. All right, Valandians. Time for you to stop running. Come face me. Oh, he's going in the castle. You know what? I'm going to face him in the castle. Oh, wait, no, he left. Oh, hold on. I don't want to fight at night. Any other time. Okay, well, oof, Valandians. Ugh. I think you outnumber me, and the balance of power is in my favor. Oh, that's embarrassing. Ugh. Yeah, they outnumber us by a little less than 100, and we have heavy advantage over them. Oh, shoot! Shoot. I just realized I'm too weak to fight. We can't fight, so I'm gonna have to send in the troops. Okay. Woo-hoo-hoo! Sorry, guy. I literally was going to fight that. I know I auto-resolved probably more than you like, but I didn't want to auto-resolve that one. And oh my gosh, look at all these prisoners. That's embarrassing. Okay, so we're going to head straight back over to the city so we can drop these prisoners off. Oh, shoot. That's right. We don't control the city, so I can't donate any prisoners here. So I guess I'll hold on to these vassals that I captured in the battle and just, I don't know, force them to march with my army and... force them to watch me conquer all of their territory. That's going to be fun. Oh, and I think I'm going to go ahead and call my wife into the army. Oh, just kidding. Someone else called her. And who's calling you? Who you got calling you? Only I should be calling you, you stupid whore. All right, awesome. They just took this castle here. So I think these armies are going to continue to... they're just going to keep going. All right, off to the next city. Okay, hold up here. So we're sieging here, but they're sieging the castle we just took, which is kind of annoying. Hopefully my vassals can deal with that. But for now, I'm actually gonna... Can we call anybody? No, all the lords are occupied. We barely outnumber the garrison, so we're gonna rely heavily on the artillery. So just make sure we build up all the artillery, all the siege equipment we can. Let our army heal up while we continue the siege. And then, you know, bada bing, bada boom, we're going to take it. Bitty boppity, I'm coming for your property. Yo, this is nice. Is he coming to help me? Yo, he's coming to help me. Look at this. One of my armies. Are they going to join? Oh, bless them. Bless them. This is going to make this so much easier. Oh, but there's an army of 700 moving out. You see that? That makes things a little bit trickier. All right, because of that army I saw from the Valandians, looks like he was moving over to... Yeah, he's taking a castle back or something. Okay, so I'm just going to send in the troops. We might... Oh, we lost a lot. Oh, you know why? It's because they had all those catapults. Yikes. Well, that's okay. We took a city. I'm going to go ahead and trade all of our loot and go help out the other settlements that are under attack. Yeah, one of our castles are under siege, and then we need to go ahead and trade away this new city, which again, it's going to be this guy, because I believe this is our newest vassal. I believe he has a very large clan. So he's going to need a lot of territory, which is fine by me. Perfectly fine by me. But no one is defending this castle. Like, why aren't you... You know what? Maybe at this point, I'm going to tell my vassals to be defensive, please. Be defensive. Defend our castle, would you? Whoa! Are we doing all right here? No, we are not. Holy crap, we got to get over there. I don't think we're going to get there. Oh, wait, no. We're fine. We're fine. Okay. I didn't see that other army there, you know? All right, we're okay. All right, so that's that army of 700 gone. So no wonder... Oh, beautiful, guys. See, it's nice winning battles, isn't it? It feels good. All right, so I have taken control of pretty much all of the cities that originally are... that belong to the Batanians. At this point, I have liberated the Batanians. Now, there's still a ton of castles that we have to take control of. I'm just going to go ahead and shimmy over this way. Make sure that this city is being defended properly. I have a feeling that they're going to take it here. It could be just one little vassal attacking, which might be the case. Yep, that's exactly what's happening. Okay, okay. So at this stage of the war, honestly, like, this has been an extreme cakewalk. Like, this has been so easy. So I think what we need to do now, and, like, we could negotiate peace, but my vassals are not having it. So what we could do now is just go for the castles. Just make sure we gain control of every bit of territory in our area. And I think we're going to be fine. I think we're going to be just fine. All right. Okay. Now things have gotten interesting. The Western Empire declares war on us. So that changes some things. This is where I get kind of sad. Well, here's the good news. We utterly gutted the Volandians. And my guys support 100% peace. And we're going to go ahead and request peace with the Volandians. They are going to give us 300 gold per day, which is not much, but at least it's not breaking the bank. We didn't get these castles that I wanted, but that's okay. We got the cities, which is most important. And oh my gosh, there's an army already forming over here. Look at that. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing. I'm actually going to disband this army. And we are going to recruit along the way. And once again, we're going to try to take this city and this city. That is the goal. Look how much stronger we are now compared to the Western Empire. We outnumber them in strength by double. Almost double. But yeah, we have like 10,000 more strength than them. I've got a feeling that we're finally going to be able to chip away at the Western Empire. All right, so I summoned an army. I'm almost in position. This army is on the march right now, and I'm going to head to this city over here. Now, just because we're double the strength of the Western Empire doesn't mean that they're going to push over. They're just going to, you know, not put up a fight. They certainly are going to put up a fight, but, and look at, of course. All right, let's go defend our city first, guys. All right, we're going to head back to this city and defend it. Of course they go. They love this city. They gotta have it. Woo! 2,000 men. Wow. That's a lot of troops. They only have a ram. Let's see what happens here. I'm not gonna rush in just yet. I feel like my defenders can actually do a decent job here. Alright, they're still at 300 strong. I think once they're at like 100 strength, we're gonna move in. Wow, they're kicking their butts right now. Look at that. 239. They're at 215, 201. Okay, they're at 100. So it's do or die, baby. I don't want to wait any longer. Let's go in and save this fortification. Now, I'm actually going to wait a little bit so it's a little sunnier. Imagine the defenders being like, hey, look, there's a relief force. Wait, what are they doing? They're just sitting there. Why are they just sitting there? All right, let's go in. Oh, yeah. Even battle. Even Steven. But we're going to go in anyways. We're going to win this. All right. So we got ourselves a bridge battle again. And the question is, are they going to push forward and attack? That might be the case. So I'm going to... Let's set up the army here. I got my archers here. I'm going to put all my cav over here. Okay. So I've got my archers here. What I'm going to do is try to put the archers like right here. And then send forward the cav, the horse archers, and the infantry to deal with their cav. Because their cav is going to be pretty strong, but I think mixed in with the infantry, we're going to be okay. So here we go. Let me, watch out, guys. I need to advance. Yeah, our army is, there's some weak troops in there. Definitely not as strong as theirs in terms of quality. Okay, it does appear... Let's see, are they going to push forward? Oof. They are pushing forward with horse archers, but that's it. I will gladly face these horse archers. Oh, good blocks. Now they're in range of my archers. I just don't want to rush into things, you know? We got to just take our time here. It's a delicate situation. We could easily lose. There we go. First blood. Okay, they are moving across. Excellent. So, archers. Let's get the archers in position. Let's move up the cav. Cav infantry moving up. Let's go, guys. There's an army waiting for our embrace. All right, so the archers should start opening fire here. You know what?
Cavalry.
Can we, all right, let's charge.
Attack! Soldier, horse, cavalry, brutal!
Charge! All right, so I'm gonna command from the hill. There we go, this is nice. I like this little setup here because their flank, oh boy. Their flank is kind of exposed to our infantry. This is not bad. It's not great. You know what? I'm gonna fall everybody back. I'm falling everybody back. Fall back, men. Fall back. We're gonna rely heavily on my archers. Basically, just trying to get out of the way for the archers. I guess we can't fall completely back. But by getting them to get a little bit closer to us, our archers are going to do more damage. And I'm going to do some damage too. There we go. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Team effort, baby. Team effort. Oh, what a shot. What an absolute shot. All right, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's go ahead and regroup all our melee units. So I'm regrouping. Again, not forcing the fight. Making him come to me. See how they're just trickling in? That's perfect. I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to get behind this rock here so their archers can't hit me. And then shoot at the flank of the infantry that are advancing on my men. All right, here comes their cav. Let's go ahead and match their cav, charge in our cav, charge in our infantry as well. Beat them piecemeal, guys. Yeah, there we go. There we go. All right, fall back. Okay, hold on. I gotta get back into position. I wish you could set up like waypoints to like, you could simply tell them to, like, fall back, you know, and they know where to go because you set up a fall back point. You know what I mean? Okay, so I'm falling back my... Oh, my goodness. They have a lot more cav. Here comes the next wave, lads. Hold strong. Hold fast. All right, I'm going to move up my infantry. I'm going to put my infantry into... I'm going to put my infantry into shield wall. There we go. Nice, nice. Holding the front line against their cav. Meanwhile, our cav's just chilling, staying fresh, resting. We're playing the long game here, guys. Taking our time. This is a very even battle. This is a difficult battle. Difficult battle. Trying to get these enemies away from my back lines. Oops, sorry. All right, here comes another big wave of troops. I might have to charge in my cav to support the infantry. No, no, they just keep trickling in. This is good. This is really good. I wish there was like a patrol option too. Like you could have your cav patrol an area. So like they will attack anyone who comes near them instead of just standing there. Hold infantry. You brave men, you are the front line. You are the wall of Longdongia. All right, I'm starting to think the enemy's starting to run out of ammo, which is really good. What we want them to run out of next? Oh yeah, they pretty much are out of infantry and cav. They have one cav. Yeah, this is it. Okay. So let's move up the infantry. Advance, infantry, advance. I'm going to go ahead and charge my cav. While this infantry is soaking up all the shots, I'm going to tell my archers to advance so they can get a little bit closer. All right, infantry, go ahead and go into line formation and then charge. Perfect timing. Perfect timing. Charge! Yes! This is where we turn the tide of the battle. We've exhausted their cav and their archers. Jeez, look at all these archers. This is ridiculous. All right, archers. Archers. Hold here. Hold here and fire at them. Like point blank fire. This is still anyone's game. They have so many freaking archers in their army. I hate how the Western Empire does that. Like, I'd rather... That's probably why I like fighting the Valandians more than anything else. Like, being able to fight cav is so much better than fighting archers. There we go. Yes, sir. How do you have so many Sturgeons in this army? It's weird. All right, excellent. So we're gonna win the battle, but by the skin of our teeth. Oh, and I died. Okay. Right at the end. All right, awesome, guys. So we lost 491 men. More than I wanted, but a victory is a victory, okay? We're gonna take some prisoners here. Oh, and we unlocked 29 troops, so that's pretty swell. That was a fun battle, pretty challenging. It was a big archer battle, but patience was the key to that victory. So let's continue onward to our original objective, which is this city right here. Whoa, look who's got another army built up. Hello, I mean, do you wanna fight? Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. Are you going? Where are you going? Just fight me. Oh, there we go. There we go. Wow. Another close battle. Let's fight this one too. Well, guys, it looks like this is going to be another archer battle. They have 240 archers, about 120 cav, 45 infantry, and 6 horse archers. We have 249 archers, 203 infantry, and about 114 cav. So, I think we have the advantage here. And is he seriously just charging in his cav? Okay. I'm just going to move up my infantry in front of my archers, and then I'm just going to charge in my cav and my horse archers. Excuse me, sir. No. I'm commanding. Coward. Only a coward goes for their general. No general sniping. All right, so my cav's holding the front. The archers are doing their thing. I don't know why they're charging in their cav like this. Oh. Come here. But if we can clean up their cav, it's gonna be easy, because I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna move up my infantry into shield wall and then get close to those archers and then charge. Unless I die. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and move up my infantry now. Battle's looking good so far. We are winning the cav battle. And again, they outnumber our archers, and that's gonna be the biggest threat. In fact, well, no, he's moving them up. I'm thinking about moving back my cav. My infantry's moving forward, but they're moving in shield wall. I'm moving up my archers as well, so that way the archers can soak up some of that fire. What are you doing? Are you following me, Blood Axe? You know what I need to do? I need to set up a bodyguard unit to just, like, get, like, 6 horsemen to follow me around. Oh, yeah, perfect, perfect. So my cav, you know what? Forget it. These archers are kind of stuck in a melee with my cav. I'm actually going to tell my infantry to do line formation and then just charge. Just charge right into the heart of these archers. Go, guys, go. Oh, we're crushing them, guys. We're crushing them. This battle's way easier than the last battle. All right, there goes my infantry. There they go. Oh, that's beautiful. Just beautiful. Look at all that green in the kill feed. I'm done with you, Western Empire. Done. Done with you. Oh yeah, my infantry's just chewing them up, guys. And this guy wants to fight me, and now he's dead. This guy wants to fight me, now he's dead. This guy's got a crossbow, and ooh, I got hit there, hold on. Oh, he's still hanging, tough guy, but he's dead. All right, we got sniped, but that's all right. We won the battle, and there goes, I don't know why my army's retreating, it's kind of annoying. Whatever. We're gonna win anyways. We just gotta clean up their... I guess their cav kind of beat ours. It doesn't matter. We killed 337. They only killed 146 of us. We're definitely gonna have to call in another vassal to join us because we're so light on troops. But we just destroyed two big armies, so that's awesome. All right, cool. Mission accomplished. Well, we got a bunch of loot that I'm gonna go to the city and sell. I'm also gonna go ahead and let... I'm gonna let you go, and you go. We're gonna replace them with other vassals that have stronger armies, just so they can go out and, you know, recruit more troops and strengthen their numbers again. Oh, awesome. So our other armies here, I think we have two armies here. They just, or is it just one army? It's two. They just took a castle, so... We're gonna go ahead and give it away. We'll give it to this guy. Give it away now. There's another army here of 300, but I'm not too worried about it. We're just gonna keep moving. Let's not forget the main objective, this city right here. This is so good, guys. We currently have four armies. We got two here, we have my army, and then we have another army in the north that's taking a castle. Dude, like this is beautiful. This is so great. And you know, I can't wait for this war to end. As long as we take a couple cities here, what I'm going to do is exactly the same thing. I'm going to go and hire more vassals, recruit more vassals into the kingdom, and we're going to be unstoppable. All right, so we finally caught up to the city, and we are going to go ahead and lay siege to it. They have 600 defenders, but that's going to be nothing for my army. All right, guys, so we're good to go, and let's not forget, this is a revenge siege battle, okay? Remember, we fought this battle not too long ago, and we had to pull back. I guess it was a defeat, but yeah, let's go ahead and jump into this battle and finally take this city once and for all. Knock, knock! Hey, stop peeking out of there. Hey, I see you. Huh? You think you could just shoot at my guys? Nah, not for long. Come on, guys, bring it down. Bring it down. One more. One more hit, come on. Okay, one more, I lied. Yeah, charge. I don't wanna be the first one in. Why? Cause I'm gonna flank around them, ready? Come on, bring it down. Oh, flank. Yeah, just like that. All right, we got ourselves in a little bit of a situation. Oh. Did you see that guy in the background fall off the wall and die? Okay. Well, that's four less. Oh, dang it. It's just they all attack at different times. Okay. That's one less enemy. There's another. Dang it! Ah! Oh, jeez, guys, are we gonna lose? Look at the bounce of power. This is not looking good. Come on, guys. Come on, we're gonna break through, right? Man, what a defense. What a defense. Holy crap. I gotta give them credit here, man. I think we're gonna win, but like, by the skin of our teeth. No wonder I couldn't take this city. This is just like such a solid city to defend. Look at there. There we go. We're pushing over here. No, I don't know, guys. Are we gonna take this or not? I don't know. Now my archers are charging in. This is close. Okay, I think we got it. Wow. If I would have known, like, I wouldn't have been so reckless. Dang, dude. We won, but dang. The skin of our teeth. Look at that, they killed 400. Wow. Whew. All right, so let's send in the troops. We have 122. Oh my gosh. We have 500 wounded right now. Wow. Truly unbelievable. But we took the city, and I'm going to trade some loot and prisoners. So I'm just going to chill in this city for some time, you know? I'm just going to relax here for a little bit. We're going to give this city away. I guess we'll give it to you. All right, cool. So since we've given the city away, I'm going to go ahead and keep pushing. I'm going to go ahead and summon more vassals into the army. And I'm actually going to let anyone that has like 40 or less troops out of here so they can like remuster up an army, you know? So that should be good. Let's go to the next settlement, which is going to be right here. Oh, awesome. We got an army here who just defended the castle. They just got a bunch of prisoners. That's perfect. We're in position to siege this castle now. So we're going to begin the siege. They have 600 defenders. Hey, dude, I'm not going to assume this is going to be easy like the last siege battle. I'm going to take my time here. We got this army of 291. It's not a big army, but I am worried about it because they could go and attack one of our recently taken cities. But it does say he's coming over to defend. So I don't know what he expects to do here. Wow, my vassals want to declare war on the Azurai. Ooh, I want to do that, but first I want to deal with the Western Empire. Like, I want to at least take this one last city, and then I'll declare war on the Azurai. He's got 1,000 troops here, 1,100. Ooh. What are you doing, guys? What are you doing? Oh, I might have to help there. I might have to. Oh, we can't. I'm sorry. We can't lose here. I'm not going to let my troops die here. Guys, quickly. Please, quickly. Get over there. No. Don't surrender. We're coming, baby. We're coming. Right in time. Oh, yeah. We can send in the troops. Easy peasy. Yep. You're welcome. All right. So let's go back to sieging this city. Let's see if he's going to help us. Oh, he's coming to help us. Let's see, how much does that change? Okay, cool. But again, I'm not going to make the same mistake twice. I'm going to destroy their artillery before we charge in. Oh, now he's leaving. Oh, come on, no. Just wait a little. Where are you going? Oh, you're going to defend a castle? Okay, I respect it. Well, here's another army of 900. Maybe he'll join us. Come on, join us. Oh, yeah, he's about to join us. Oh, yeah. All right, so we have 2,000, they have 500. We just destroyed most of their artillery. This should be easy peasy, and sure enough, it was not. We lost 375, give me a break. All right, so we took two cities. They only have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more. Wow. Let's see if we can take one more city before we negotiate peace. The only thing is that, here, you know what? I'm gonna disband the army so these guys can go heal up. Because we've been through a lot. The only thing is that my vassals do want to go to war with the Azurai, and I'm for that. I'm completely... Oh, you know what? The Western Empire's at war with the... Oh, okay. All right, never mind. Let's just keep attacking the Western Empire while they're busy fighting the Azurai. Yeah. And like the first time in forever, guys... another faction's at war with another faction. It felt like everyone was just at war with us. I'm gonna go ahead and summon another army, guys. I'm gonna look for lords that, well, actually, I'll just take all the lords available because there's not much. And look at this, an army of 500 trying to siege us. Oh, he's running for it. No, sir. Never mind. We gotta wait until we got, there we go. Now we'll go in. We needed those reinforcements. There we go. We can send in the troops. Easy peasy. Okay, so let's move to the nearest city. This is going to be the third city of this war, which is absolutely fantastic. Now, oof. They have 700 defenders in here. No, make that 800. Okay. Wowie. So we're definitely going to need to wait for some reinforcements before we decide to siege it. I'm just going to chill in front of the gate to prevent any more vassals from joining the defense of this city. Guys, it feels so good to finally break through the Western Empire and take massive amount of territory. All right, so let's go ahead and lay siege to the castle. They do have a couple vassals in this castle, which is going to make it a little bit more challenging. But I'm not too worried about it. Okay, the Kuzates have just declared war on us. Interesting. That might make my vassals want to accept peace with the Western Empire. The Kuzates have... they think that they've been able to build a slightly stronger force. They think they can go to war with us. We're now at 23,000 strength. Okay, guys, that's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. So at the very least, let's take this final city and then we'll negotiate peace with the Western Empire. All right, so I was extra careful in this battle because we barely outnumber them. I destroyed both the walls, so that should make the attack on the settlement a little bit easier. All right, guys, here we go. Through the walls. Through the walls. Yeah, it's probably going to be a while until we can actually help out. So what I'm going to do is just shoot at enemies that I see on the wall. And then once we break through, then I'll break through and help out in the melee. Oh, here we go. Wow, that didn't take long at all. Okay. Sweet. Oh, there's a lot of archers back there. Hey, push. Yeah, clean out this corner. There we go. Yeah. Take the walls, lads. Take the city. Like I said, once we take this city, I'm going to negotiate peace because I'm pretty... Oh, they're pushing us back. Yeah, I'm going to negotiate peace because I'm pretty certain they'll accept it, and my vassals will probably want to accept it too. Because we got to deal with the Kuzates now, who randomly declared war on us. They're actually doing a decent job of holding us back. Now, thankfully, we got our ram into position. So this should help us give another position to attack. Wow, my guys are not attacking the gate. It's all... That was rude. Hey, can we attack this gate? Because we need another opening here, guys. I almost got it, but they're shooting at me. Where is he? Oh, no. But I need to get through the gate. Oh, thank you. Open the gate for me. All right, we're winning, but barely. Dang, dude. And I don't think I'm going to survive. I don't have enough health for this. Yep, see? That's all right. With the gate open, that's another point of attack. And I think we're going to be okay. We just got to keep pushing in. Yeah, we're going to be fine. We've got these guys surrounded now. Surrounded! Whew. All right, battle finished. And we lost 200. All right, we're going to send in the troops to finish off the rest. And we got a bunch of prisoners as well. We unlocked some troops, so that's awesome. Okay, so now that we took this city, look at this. The Western Empire has crumbled to just 4 cities. We are taking a castle over here, which I respect. We are under siege over here by the Kuzates. So, look at this. We gained a ton of territory in this episode. I honestly, at this point, nobody stands a chance against us. And I'm looking at my diplomacy, and nobody wants peace. Nobody wants peace. Like, I think the most is 25% against the Sturgeons. They want peace. I'm not going to pay the Sturgeons 650 gold a day for... No. So, I guess, guys, we'll just keep pushing. I think what I'm going to do, actually, because I don't want the Kuzates to start taking territory from us because we're so busy with the Western Empire. I'm going to let these guys, I'm just going to fast forward, let these guys take this castle over here. And once they take it, then I'm going to negotiate peace. Hopefully, I mean, we should probably have enough influence to force it, even if my vassals don't want peace. But we need to kind of focus on the Kuzates. And I'm actually going to go ahead and disband the army too, so they can go off and start recruiting more troops. Come on, guys, take the castle. Take the freaking castle. Whoa, there's a big battle going on. I think we're going to win. We're going to easily win. Holy moly. Oh, yeah. Western Empire, I don't know, as much as I... the Batanians declared war on us, so that's not a problem. As much as I want peace, I don't know, maybe... Oh, there we go, they took it. They took the castle, okay. So, since they took the castle, 64% support peace, and we'll receive 2,900 tribute. I think I'm gonna go ahead and accept that.
And so, after crippling the Western Empire and taming the Vlandians, nothing would stand in the way of Long Dongia. Khanid Longest Dongus and his vassals took city after city, castle after castle, and Long Dongia grew and grew. Enemy Lord saw the writing on the wall and soon joined Longus and his empire. And they were greatly rewarded for it, just as Longus promised. With 90% of Kalradia conquered, Khanid Dongus spared the Vlandians to the west and the Kuzates to the east. Their kings bent their knee and Longus Dongus became a king of kings, using their kingdoms as buffer states. After conquering the world, Longus ruled for 25 years, and Ira, his wife, birthed him 10 sons. And later these sons each had 10 children as well. His blooded line spanned many kingdoms and generations. And yes, you might even say you might have a little Dongus inside you. After 25 years of rule, Longus passed the throne to his eldest son, named Dingus Dongus, long may he rule, and he was never seen again. Some say he ascended and became a god. Others say he was bored of peace and traveled to distant lands to conquer. But I like to think he changed his appearance and bought a farm on the edge of the empire. And he grows all of the best dick-shaped fruits and vegetables like carrots, eggplants, bananas, and so much more. It is of my belief he would travel to local markets and sell his produce to commoners. Little did they know they were buying food from the great Khanid Longus Dongus. Every night for the rest of his life, he would watch the sunset in solitude, surrounded by his hard work and harvest until the day he died. And so that is the story of the great Longus Dongus, the man who straddled the world.
Most in my life, they say you're out of my league, but I don't give a damn. No, deep down, I know you want it. You wanna take a leap and jump in. You wanna fall in love. You get me spinning, wouldn't it be awesome if you just kiss me slowly and had me in your arms? If I could make you see it, baby, with me something. Oh,
times to think about all the ways I'm making you smile. I know I am what you need, and boy, you're just my type. Deep down, I know you want it. You wanna take a leap and jump in.